We're back.
That was wonderful. Thank you, guys. I really loved it. I have a couple more questions. Now, I want to ask, and we've talked about the history of this instrument. I'd like to know a little bit more about the ney and the kaval. Where did they originate? Do you know, or?
Nereden geliyor?
It's in 14th century.
Okay.
Rumi, maybe you heard. Mevlana Celaleddin Rumi.
Mevlana
Rumi.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, he used this instrument.
Okay.
And also it has a deep philosophy inside, because there is 7 holes.
Okay.
It means we have 7 holes in head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It was before, it was in the ground, the reed.
Uh-huh.
It was with cut, and then we cut it to the world. It's a human being.
Okay.
And it's crying, his voice is like crying, because he's missing God.
Okay.
There's a philosophy like this.
Wow.
His voice is really very deep.
So it has a deep meaning, everything about the instrument.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this is a Sufism.
Sufism,
yes.
Yeah, Sufism.
Yeah, because when I was in, I told you I traveled to Turkey last summer. Oh, anyway, when I was in Istanbul, I went to see the Sufi, where
yes.
they do the
Mevlevi
ceremony. Yeah, and it was
yeah.
at the old train station,
yeah.
and it was awesome.
Yeah,
it was really awesome. In fact, everything yeah. about Istanbul was awesome.
Yeah.
I have to go back. Now, tell me about the kaval.
Kaval is most used in Turkish folk music.
Okay. And do you know
it's
where
similar to ney, but
okay.
ney is, I think, deep,
okay.
a deep voice.
Deep
they
ney.
Have a little bit
okay.
more different techniques.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, you know what? I think we're going to go to the next song. I think we're ready to do that.
Mm.
So let's do it.